Good morning. You guys are looking great, by the way. Even the Wolves fans look good. That's when you know it's a special soccer morning. We appreciate you all coming. On behalf of the management and the staff here, we want to welcome you to the new Jack Daniel's Club here at Werner Park. My name's Donnie Barnes, and we have a few housekeeping items before we start today. First of all, for media members, one-on-one interviews will be available with these gentlemen after the end of this press conference, so you all get your time with them. So we appreciate your patience there. We will also have hospitality available for all of you at the conclusion of this press conference, so feel free to stick around and socialize after we wrap up. Also, if you want to move, if some of you want to scoot in on the sides here, there is some room, so if you're at the back and you can't see, feel free to come over here on the sides, and we'll pack in as soon as possible. That's what we get for having such a great turnout. Awesome. We'll give a second for the mass migration over here so people can see. This is such an exciting morning. This is a historic morning. It's a historic morning in the continued growth of the Omaha Metro sports scene. It's a historic morning in the continued growth of Sarpy County. And of course, it's another historic moment in the explosive growth of the sport of soccer, both here in our backyard and in our nation. And the first man I want to introduce this morning has been at the forefront of that growth over the past 10 years. So please join me in welcoming the Senior Vice President of USL League One, Stephen Short.
Good morning, and wow, look at this room. If you guys could see what I could see, you'd be thrilled, and probably more than I am, although I do see the Wolverhampton stuff back there, and we'll have to talk about that later today. I think there's some Liverpool fans in here today as well, so we'll have to work through that. But today's not about that. And today is about Omaha and Sarpy County and growing professional soccer in the United States. And before I really dive into a couple of things, I'd like to say some thank yous if I could. And first, to those that are here that have made today happen, with the ownership and Gary and your team, it's been a tremendous honor to work with you. And there's a lot of people that you probably have seen moving around the room or haven't seen over the last couple months, whether it's here or in Tampa, but I'd like to thank the Werner Park team for making today's event possible. I know you get your accolades at different times, you may be behind the scenes, and that's where a lot of us live, but thank you for your efforts. And I'd also like to thank the USL team in Tampa, Florida. There are over 60 executives in Tampa supporting this event this morning, making sure that the news for Omaha and Sarpy County can get out and everyone can digest that. So I just wanna say thank you for everyone and your help and your support, and let's get the celebration moving. Earlier this morning, and I think it's a regular question we'll receive is Omaha. What makes Omaha interesting for USL League One and USL as a whole? And there are three things we always look at when it comes to expansion markets and the success of the league. First is the ownership. We always will make sure that we have a strong ownership in place that will sustain the club and move it throughout the community. The community is number two, not specifically in that order, because the community supports the club. And when we look at Omaha, the region, the metro region, and Sarpy County, we look at a strong soccer scene. We look at an amazing corporate environment, and we look at a young, vibrant community that will continue to grow in size and in passion for this game. And that's what attracts us as a league to look at a market. And honestly, I would tell you, this started a couple years ago. This is not an overnight venture. So to know that we were on that years ago, and the ownership and the team and the community saw that, we were excited to be here for that. The third element is the stadium. And if you look here at Werner Park, and we're going to go into some things later today, I don't want to steal Gary's thunder and what you guys are working on, but we're excited to see that starting in 2020, there are going to be fans inside this stadium that are banging drums and setting off non-incendiary smoke devices. We have to make sure that you understand they're non-incendiary, they're called Coburn, but they're safe in stadiums throughout the country. And you'll see flags, and we're seeing that in like markets right now in Madison, Wisconsin, this weekend with Ford Madison's launch and their first home game in what was threatened to be 5 to 7 inches of snow, but turned out to be 2. But still had 4,400 people inside their stadium, and there will be another 500 to 1,000 in every game chanting and singing and cheering their community on. So it starts in the stadium, but spreads out into the community, and we're thrilled to be here. We're excited for you. We're excited to see how you rally around this team, your drums, your flags, your signs, your chants, and your songs, and how those will invade the community and really become part of your core. For USL League One, it's also been a journey. And our COO, Justin Papadakis, can attest to this, where a couple years ago, when we moved the USL up to Division Two, we said, you know what, let's launch Division Three pro soccer. Let's really create a foundation for professional soccer in this country. Let's provide access to professional soccer to many communities across the country that currently don't have it. That represented about 75 million people in 249 markets. Now, we're not going to go into 249 markets. I want to be upfront about that. But we're choosing the best to come into League One and to continue to thrive. As we look at that, we're also trying to make sure that they can support a team of their own and not one that's 3 hours away, 4 hours away, or hundreds of miles away. We want to make sure that they can support their community and take that community to the world. As part of that with USL League One, that's really helped us is our ESPN Plus partnership. So now, no matter where you are in the U.S., you can watch your Omaha club on ESPN Plus. If you're somewhere around the world, you can watch it on YouTube and make sure that you can support your community no matter where you're at. It's also been great for the first time in a pro league to have that in year one, that we can make sure that not only are we seeing our professional athletes and our teams are growing, but we're also going to be able to take the Omaha community even more domestic and more global. In our first year, we've seen some amazing history already. We've seen our first hat trick happened in the first game in North Texas. We've seen our first national team player call up, and we've also witnessed three soccer-specific stadium designs that have been revealed. And so we're excited to see that there is this investment in the game of soccer and its growth, and we continue to make history. But because no one really likes to hear from the league, they want to hear about what's going to happen in Omaha, what I'd like to do is go ahead and invite Gary up, and hopefully we can make some more history real quick, and then let you get into the rest of the day, and let's celebrate the city. So Gary, on behalf of the USL CEO, Al Papadakis, and our team, we'd like to formally welcome you into League One for 2020.
If you want to hold that?
Thank you, Stephen. And thanks everybody in here. There's besides this being an incredible day, there's so many incredible people in this room that have supported us throughout since I've been here in 2012, and it's great. Always great to see everybody together and in this new room, in this new club that we have that's been, you know, part of our dream since we came here in 2012. But thank you everybody for being here. I have a lot of thank yous, so let me get that out of the way first. I want to thank the USL specifically, Alec Papadakis, he's the president. Alec is the CEO, Alec Papadakis, the president, Jake Edwards, and Justin Papadakis for being here today and making this day possible. And it's been 2 years in the making, so you know it's an emotional day for me. I also want to take this opportunity to recognize a lot of other people that helped us get to this point. It truly does take a village, and it's been 2 years in getting this to this point, and I wanted to thank some folks. So my business partner, Larry Botel, our president and general manager, Marty Cordero, assistant general manager, Lori Schlender, Sarpy County Administrator, Dan Hoynes, deputy county administrator, Scott Bovic, county commissioners, Don Kelly, Jim Warren and Gary Mixon, our Storm Chaser investors, and Dan Houghton of Builder Trend. And finally, she's not here, but my lovely wife, Amy, she supported me through this many sleepless nights and endless soccer conversations in putting this deal together. So the USL, we'll get a lot of questions today of what the USL is about, and a lot of the soccer fans that are in the crowd know exactly what it's about. But the USL's vision is what soccer needs in the U.S. And it's not only grown the sport, but even more importantly, it has had huge and positive shifts in cities and communities across the country. In Louisville, Memphis, Madison, and Albuquerque, to name a few, USL franchises have not only transformed sports in these cities, but have brought an energy and passion to communities never seen before. Like these other USL cities, we intend for the Omaha Metro to experience this seismic shift. It's been a long journey to get to this point, over 2 years to be exact. And in that time period, we have not only stepped into the strong and proud vision of the USL, but we have also begun to understand what soccer means in the Omaha Metro. The Omaha and Sarpy soccer community has been yearning for a team to call their own. But more importantly, it deserves a team to call their own. And today they get their team. Soccer is a sport about community, and it's about embracing everyone within that community. Fans work together, not just in the sport, but in the movement. And once our ownership of the USL soccer franchise, I just want to be very clear on something and restate something that the great Omaha native Warren Buffett told me. He told me this in 2012 when I met with him to buy the Storm Chasers. And he looked at me very directly and leaned forward. And when Warren Buffett leans forward, you better be quiet and listen. He said, "You may own this franchise on paper, but this team belongs to Omaha." These words from Mr. Buffett have stuck with me since then. It is the fans that take ownership in the franchise and not the other way around. We are proud to be the stewards and caretakers of the world's game and the big O for all the fans. And it starts today, right now. We are asking everyone in the Omaha Metro, not just soccer fans, to tell us what they love about their community. We will also be hosting various gatherings in the coming weeks so we can hear from the soccer community directly, not just what they want to see in the Crest, but what they want to see in their club. Finally, I am extremely excited to share that our team will include a familiar local presence. It's no secret that the greater Omaha region is home to some of the world's biggest corporate names and success stories. You all know that better than I do. One local entrepreneur epitomizes more than anyone else in the community the future of Omaha business. Please join me in welcoming to our team Dan Houghton, co-founder and executive vice president of BuilderTrend.
This is a great group. So this is a really exciting day for me, and as we've talked, and as you've already heard, this has been 2 years in the making. I looked at my first email with you. It was exactly 2 years ago. This all happened really out of a conversation that I had with Kyle Peterson, who's a baseball guy and also one of the other local investors that we have here. We were talking about what's going to make Omaha great in the future. How do we build a community around athletics? What does this city need to have over the next 20 years to really be one of the premier cities in our country, quite honestly? And it's interesting to me how you look at all these markets around the country, and teams, sports, bring communities together. And it doesn't matter where you're from, where you live, what gender you are, what race you are. I believe soccer has this global and this power to bring people from all over the world together. I mean, look at the World Cup. It's an incredible thing, quite honestly. Omaha is ready for this. Omaha needs this. We've seen some great things happen in our community over the last 20 years, including, the success of Creighton soccer, the success of UNO soccer, the success of the junior programs. But it's time. Today's the day. It's time to have professional soccer in Omaha, Nebraska. And I could not be more proud to be part of a great local investment group that's part of this. So some of those folks that I'd like to recognize today, Kyle Peterson, Ren Smith, Mike Castling, that are here today, among a lot others, that have just been saying yes. They said yes. And that takes a lot of courage, and very thankful for the support that you guys have brought to this. It means a lot. So over the last 2 years, I've literally gone from, an education of soccer at preschool to maybe sixth grade at this point. So I'm still learning as we go. But what I have learned is I went out to the community, I've talked to folks in soccer, I've talked to corporate leaders, I've talked to community leaders, and I asked the simple question, will you support this? Will you support it by going to the games? Will you take your children to the games? Will you bring your friends to the games? Will you sponsor these games? And everyone I talked to was so excited about this opportunity, and that's what's going to make this fantastic. And I'm just proud to be in this room. I'm proud to stand in front of you. And, more importantly, I want to thank Gary and Larry for their leadership to get this to the finish line. They are a big part of our community, and very thankful for that. So, also, I can't spoil it, but we have a world-class coach that's going to win us a lot of games. I'm pretty excited about that. So, thank you. Thanks for being here, and we're looking forward to a really successful team. Thanks.
Thanks, Dan. It's great to have you a part of this. Our next speaker this morning, many of you know him as the longtime president and general manager of the Omaha Storm Chasers, and as if that doesn't keep him busy enough, he's also spent the last couple of years helping spearhead the development of this new soccer club. Please welcome President and General Manager Marty Cordero.
What's up, Omaha and Sarpy County and Nebraska? How we doing? Really? I thought this was a soccer crowd. I keep hearing how loud it's going to be. That's better. You know, it has been quite the run here at Warner Park, right here in Sarpy County. I can't tell you how excited our entire organization is to welcome USL here. In talking with Steven yesterday and a little bit this morning, I was sharing, you know, how excited we are to learn. You know, we've been a part of minor league baseball for 51 years, but this is an opportunity to learn from another great, growing organization. So welcome to USL right here in Sarpy County and Omaha. Thank you. We expect nothing less than what we've delivered so far here. As it relates to baseball, as it relates to special events, but more importantly, as it relates to community. And the words that Dan just talked about, community, growing, business leaders, all those things go into what we've done. So that's exciting. That's exciting to hear, having local investors that are here. So thank you all for being a part of what we're doing. I want to thank our staff. Lori Schlender, I don't know where you are in the room, in the back. She and I have been working alongside Gary and Larry and a number of others for about 2 years, and we've been talking about it longer than that, as we've talked about a number of other business endeavors. But thank you, Lori. Andrea Bedour. Andrea runs our special events and a number of other things here. The reason this room is set up is for Andrea. Thank you. And Sean Olson as well, from a sales perspective. Sean's been along for the ride for the last about a year, year and a half. So thank you to them. Our entire staff. There is no soccer staff yet, so this wouldn't be possible today without the efforts that they've done, not only in this room, the great Jack Daniels Club, but also throughout the ballpark. So thank you all for your efforts. I'm now proud to introduce our soccer COO, Matt Hominoff. Matt's professional soccer experience is impressive. 6 years with DC United and MLS, 5 years with the PDL club as the general manager of the Des Moines Menace just down the road. But it's more than just his soccer experience. From a community perspective, he said this morning, cut from the same cloth, I'm really excited to work alongside Matt. He's been on board for a couple of weeks now. Matt, if you'd stand. And let's please welcome Matt Hominoff. So the question I've been getting for the last couple of weeks is, how are you going to play soccer in a baseball facility? Well, we're going to make it a soccer facility as well. Last June of 2018, we reached an agreement, and Sarpy County Board of Commissioners voted on that. We have an agreement in place to do soccer improvements that will include new grounds maintenance building, a soccer-specific clubhouse that won't be shared with baseball, soccer front office separate from our front office, as well as the proper and necessary field modifications to have regulation field, as well as sight lines that are important in this facility. We're going to unveil some renderings. Are we ready for those renderings? It's been there. Okay. Someone got a little trigger happy. So as you can see, it's going to be an east-west orientation. We're really excited about hosting soccer in 2020. There is no schedule yet, so those that are going to ask when is the first game, we're not sure yet. That's to be announced. But we've been working with the DLR group since July of 2017. So this is not an overnight. This hasn't been just a couple of weeks, couple of months project. So we've been working on this for quite a while. And these modifications, this project would not be possible without our partnership with Sarpy County. And Gary has introduced a number of those, and I have the pleasure of introducing a friend of mine this morning. But this relationship started way back in February of 2008. I won't get into the specific meetings. I won't get into who was there, who wasn't there. But in 2008, Sarpy County wanted to learn what others in the metro didn't take the time to do. And that's what minor league baseball really was and what it was about and what it had become with the stadium explosion since the early 90s. That conversation is what has led us to today, really. And professional soccer in the metro wouldn't be coming here today without leadership of Sarpy County and a number of people over the years. So today, I get to introduce Don Kelly. Don is a chairman of the Sarpy County Board of Commissioners and is a graduate of University of Nebraska. He serves on many community boards, too many to list. Please help me welcome my friend Don Kelly. He is a retired United States Air Force colonel. So thank you for your service, Don. Please come up and let's talk.
Well, good morning, everybody. It's such a thrill for me to be up here to represent Sarpy County. I can't tell you how awesome it is to have a public-private partnership that shares a vision together. And over the several years, I've met many times with Gary and Marty, and we've thought this process through. And I just want to thank you guys for your leadership and being great teammates. I will tell you that this field out here is really Sarpy County and the Omaha area's field of dreams. This is the perfect venue for professional sports. It's been a great host of baseball, and it'll be even a better host for soccer starting next year. We have invested a significant amount of resources and time and funds to make enhancements to this stadium, and we will continue to do so. One of the first enhancements we made is the room you're standing in right now. Another thing we've done is brought our tourism out here to better forge that public-private relationship across the metropolitan community. And as Marty mentioned, those enhancements will continue with facilities that will support USL Soccer. I will tell you personally that we hope this is the first of many exciting announcements because we have great plans for what's going to be going on around this stadium as well. And I am totally confident that USL Omaha will come to understand why this area and this community is a great place to live, work, and play. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Don. It is almost time to meet the new head coach of our new soccer club. And to introduce him once again, CEO Gary Green.
So before I do that, I just want to say, you know, obviously that what we've done here, what we've created is very special, and it comes with a lot of work. And I just want to, again, give a big hand to the Storm Chaser staff, who's not only helped put this event together, but help us for the momentum to get to this point that we wouldn't be here without them. So thank you. And that blueprint, we've created that blueprint with a lot of hard work and a lot of vision. And when it came to starting the search for our new coach, we wanted to have the right blueprint. We knew how important that was. And I was about to start on that search, and when I got an email, I got an unsolicited email from UNO's head soccer coach, Bob Warming. And it was very blunt from somebody I had never spoken to, who never met before. In announcing our coach, I just wanted to read directly from that email. Coach Warming stated, "The first leader you choose to create your vision will be critical to your success. In my unsolicited opinion, there is only one man who checks all of the boxes and understands and has accomplished the daunting task of starting a top-level soccer program in Omaha. He simply knows the club youth structure in Omaha better than anyone else in the country. And this will be a critically important role, not only for marketing and support, but for many other reasons." Coach Warming continued, "I know this man well enough to know that it is his dream job, His dream job would be to work with you and establish the new team in the city he loves and calls home. This man is Jason Mims. Coach Warming, your words were all I needed to make our decision to hire Jason Mims as the inaugural USL Omaha head coach. Now, I won't share Jay's entire bio with you, and I feel like a lot of people in this room know it already, but there's some highlights I would like to share. As you know, Jay created and built the UNO soccer program from the ground up in less than 6 years. And UNO was ranked top 10 in the country, winning 3 conference championships. He was an assistant coach for 9 seasons with Creighton's soccer program, and he played soccer at St. Louis University. In total, during his NCAA career, Jay was part of 13 conference championships, 5 quarterfinals, and 2 college cups. This, in addition to his most recent role in pro soccer as assistant coach for Real Salt Lake's youth academy teams and assistant coach for the USL championship club Real Salt Lake Monarchs. Jason Mims is a coach who knows how to win and develop talent. And perhaps more importantly, he is on a crusade to build soccer in Omaha. I was excited about USL in Omaha before I met Jay. After spending the last 2 months with him, he has brought my excitement and energy level exponentially higher. Ladies and gentlemen, your inaugural USL head coach for 2020, Jason Mims.
Marty was going to do me a favor and raise these microphones, but thanks, Marty. The story about Bob, you know, as you guys know, all relationships grow, and Bob's a mentor to me, a father, a friend, best friend, brother, but I met him about 24 years ago as a high school senior taking a visit to Creighton University, and the visit was in January. And for those of you guys that know, if you're a senior in high school and you're visiting in January in Omaha, you're probably not a top recruit. So our relationship has grown to, he's meant a lot to me. So Bob, thank you. They told me I have 3 minutes to speak here. I've listened to you other guys speak, and it's been longer than that. I've been waiting for about 20 years for this moment, so damn it, this is going to be a long 3 minutes. Seriously, look around. Thank you, guys. People in here, thank you for your support. This is an unbelievable turnout, a great showing for everybody. Thank you guys so much for this. Over the last 20 years, I've had a lot of people come to other soccer people in the community and want to start professional soccer in Omaha. And people from the West Coast, people from the East Coast, people from the Midwest, people locally here, all great people, all great ideas, all intelligent conversations for 20 years. And Gary Green got it done, and he did it. And so, Gary, on behalf, I think, of not just me, but the entire soccer community here in Omaha, thank you. Thank you. So 16 home events, tailgating, Open Cup games, exhibition games versus international opponents, games from April to October. All of that stuff excites me. High-level professional soccer, but that's not what brought me back to Omaha. What brought me back to Omaha and what excites me are all of you guys, all of the people. I see so many familiar faces. I see youth coaches. I see youth directors. I see club coaches. I see college coaches. I see media members, business leaders, and that's what excites me. That's the biggest thing for me. That's why I came back here to Omaha. And for us, that's what I'm most excited about. We, together, collaboratively, can make such a huge positive impact on the community together. And that's important for me. So that's what excites me the most. I see Dan here. He was very humble, but Builder Trent is doing a lot of great stuff for Omaha, and he got us started. So Dan, thank you so much for getting us started. Really means a lot. And of course, Gary and your team and Marty and everybody, thank you guys. The league, really appreciate it. But we're going to need more support, and we're going to need more help from everybody here. And you guys know this. I know this. I'm fortunate enough with my profession to be able to travel everywhere over the country, everywhere across the world. And Omaha really is a special place. Nebraska is a special place. People just don't get it. They don't understand it from outside of here. They always ask the questions. I hear it all the time. And we get 20,000 people at basketball games, 100,000 people at football games. We get hundreds of thousands of people at the World Series. It just, people don't get how great and how supportive this town is unless you're here. And I think professional soccer, I know professional soccer is going to be a great vehicle for us to show everybody across the entire country how supportive, how passionate, and how committed we are together. And that's what I'm excited about. Thank you, guys.
Right. Is everybody else as fired up for this as I am?
Yeah.
Let's go. It's awesome hearing from you, Jay. Days like this, they're not just exciting. For those of us that have followed the soccer scene in America for a long time now, don't days like this feel almost a little vindicating too? Like, I remember the first day I stumbled on this thing called the English Premier League, on this thing called the internet in the late 90s as a teenager. And I was fascinated. It was like this whole new world that I didn't know existed. And then I started looking at Scottish soccer and German soccer and Spanish soccer. You know, teenagers, when they're going through that formative stage in their lives, they experiment, don't they? They look at different things that set them apart, that give them an identity. I experimented with soccer, and my parents were concerned at times. But to their credit, they were supportive, even though they didn't totally understand. But as a soccer nerd in the late 90s, early 2000s, you took a lot of flack, didn't you? Some of you all lived that too. People teased you, people made fun of you. It was not a cool time to be a soccer fan in America. But every time we would hear things like that, oh, soccer's boring, nobody cares about soccer, what would we say? We'd say, well, all right, whatever. You'll get it eventually. And even if you don't, this is going to keep on growing. It's already happening. It's going to happen in a uniquely American way. It's not always going to be smooth. It's not always going to be straightforward, but it is happening, and it's not going to stop. And so a morning like this, it feels pretty good, doesn't it? To stand here and celebrate the arrival of Omaha and the Sarpy County, the Omaha Metro, officially in the U.S. soccer pyramid. It's amazing. And to celebrate, as Jay just said, the birth of a new club where all of Omaha and the surrounding metro area is going to be able to gather and unite with all of our differences and all of our diversities and all of our challenges to come together and celebrate our town, our region, our state, and each other. So thank you all for being here today. Again, for media members, these gentlemen will all be available for one-on-one sessions, and there will be hospitality available, as we said. Let's go, Omaha. Let's have one more cheer for this. Let's go. Let's do it.